Zouwu or Zouwu, this was the puppet that we created, one of a couple of different heads that we made for our great creature here. But bringing the creature to life really involved us working with kind of very, very simplistic rigging. We've got a couple of handles on the back here that we'd hold on to, a little bit of strapping so we can take the weight off us and put it on our shoulders, and that would give us the head. And so bring it to life involved
getting in
and getting it up. I'm Robin Guiver and I'm a puppeteer. I'm the supervising creature puppeteer on Fantastic Beasts and The Crimes of Grindelwald. So the puppets are made by the prop making department here. Pierre Bohanna has a prop making shop that he works on these films with, and they build everything from the wands of the characters to the unique magical typewriters that sit in the corners of rooms in the Ministry of Magic. Everything that's unique in the film is built by them. So they will take the 3D models from the animators, and then they'll either do a print or a mould of a head, of a hand, of whichever part they need. The puppets that we work with have to be enough to engage the actors' imaginations, but they don't need to be as beautiful as something that you'd see in camera. So we can actually work with things that are very simple. It might just be a head that's one colour, but what's really important is there's something that's interactive. The thing that both the visual effects world and David as director were saying was these creatures have to be believable. We have to believe that they're real. And then from there we talked about how it's been kept in captivity in the circus. And so we looked at videos online of animals that had been rescued, particularly big cats, how they might behave, how trainers worked with them. So we began to look at this vocabulary of movement, this kind of shyness, this tension and aggression that these creatures have to essentially work through like a real person does with their own pain and problems. So Newt's interactions, while very brief in the film, are really loaded with this real kind of world story of rehabilitating a creature that's been abused. So with David and Eddie, we get to bring these creatures to life and really workshop with their personalities, who they are, what they want, why they want it, and then how they're going to move and act. I mean, I've got to take my hat off to Eddie Redmayne, whose imagination is that of an absolute endurance athlete. Within his really busy schedule, he always finds time to say, okay, we've got this interaction between the Zouwu or with the Niffler, with Pickett. Can we just have a look at what that is for a minute? His process is one of absolute preparation, where he's really working very hard to understand how Newt knows these creatures. Because for Newt, he's not meeting them for the first time on set. He knows exactly what they are. He's an absolute expert. And so to bring that to life, Eddie's working so hard to create his physical language with every single one of these things. When we've got the large creatures like the Arumpant or the Zouwu, they're really heavy, you know, and they're built to be as light as possible, but then we're always working with them not close to our body, not well supported, but we're having to lift them up or bring them out or then run around really fast with them. When we bring them on set, David might always say, oh yeah, I always imagine the Zouwu being, you know, kind of maybe I now see it should be a bit bigger. Can it just be a bit bigger? And so we're lifting up, okay, let's be bigger. We'll put it on the end of this rod. And we're kind of lifting things up and changing them as we go along, which makes for an extremely physically exhausting performance, because it's one thing to physically hold it there, but then also to keep it alive, to keep it animated and its eye lines really clear. It knows where it's looking, and keep it really smooth rather than shaking is physically hard work. I think there are things that our bodies do on a very subconscious level when we're looking at something real that's moving, tiny, tiny movements, that as an audience we pick that up, especially on the big screen we pick that up, we see everything. And I think it does make a big difference. The other thing about having something real is if there's a real thing in there, it can surprise you. It can do something you don't expect, go somewhere you don't know, or the director can ask us to do something different in a take that the actor's not expecting, so that we keep their performances alive. Rather than it being a completely imagined performance, it's an interactive one. And it can be interactive both physically, so they can touch things, and it's an emotional interaction as well, where you're dealing with something that has a performance and that has an imaginative life of its own. You can invest emotionally in that as well.